And now let's talk about default browser styles. So I'm going to go over here, and if I'm going to say that this is going to be heading, right? And I'm going to say that this is going to be, let's say, heading, let's say 1, right? And then we're going to copy this, and let's say we're going to make a heading 6 out of this guy, right? So we're going to say this one. It's going to be, let's say, okay, heading 3, right? So heading 3, and then we're going to make some paragraph over here, right? So we're going to say I am paragraph over here, and then we're going to have a link, right? So we're going to say href a dummy link, right? And we're going to say this is going to be a link, right? Now, our first instinct would be, right, to say that there is no styles applied to it, right? So if we go back to the main CSS and we look at it, of course, there's nothing there, right? And we don't have any inline styles here, or we don't have any internal style sheet, right? So our first thing would be say, well, okay, it doesn't have any styles, which is actually a little bit incorrect, right? So if we save this one over here, and if I have my folder over here, right? And if we go to index.html, and we're going to open over here in the full view, because otherwise we're going to break over here this live preview for the brackets. So if we'll go back over here and actually right click the actual page, right? We have an option, right? We're working with Google Chrome, and we have something inspect. Right over here, you can see that we have an option of inspect, and what this one over here is actually Google developer tools, right? So Chrome developer tools. And what's happening is over here, you can see that this is going to be the DOM, which is called document object model over here, and you can see the tree like structure, right? So you can see over here, this is going to be our heading 1, and this is going to be heading 3, and this is going to be the paragraph, right? Now notice something interesting on the right hand side over here, right? You see over here this one, it looks very similar to a style sheet, right? And the thing is, it is, right? Because every browser, there's going to be still a default style, right? And every browser is going to have a different one, right? And over here, you can see that it says user agent style sheet, right? Which stands for basically a Chrome default styles, right? Because otherwise, obviously, if you're writing this, right, it needs to display in some way, right? And it's actually useful for two reasons, right? First of all, the default styles, right, they're going to affect sometimes your layout, right? So when we're trying to actually center something or, I don't know, move it around and it's not happening, we should always go and check it out whether there isn't like some default style. Like, let's say for the body, right? For the body over here, right? First of all, you can say that there's display block, but there's also margin all around, right? So sometimes if you're trying to get something all the way to the top, you can see that it's impossible, right? Because you can see over here on the top, right? There's actually a little margin, right? So those are the things that we need to keep in mind. And second, right, we can actually go over here, right? And if we pick over here, let's say this is going to be the heading 1, right? Or the paragraph. If I go over here and you see the element style, right? We can change it on the fly and actually see how it will look like, right? So over here, I'm going to write color, and I need to spell it correctly, right? Color. And let's say that I'm going to say the color would be red, right? What you're going to see, that you can see right away that my paragraph over here, right? It's actually the color is red. Now, this is not going to stay because I only changed it in the browser and I actually didn't change it in a style sheet. However, this way we can actually quickly look at it, how the styles that we apply would actually look like in the browser.